Welcome to Turtle Tina. This course will teach you how to program using the Python language. The code you write will draw designs and objects that can be printed on a 3D printer, such as pendants, window decorations, cookie cutters, chess pieces, and much more. You will be learning Python, a versatile language used in science, math, and many apps. The very first Turtle programs were based on Logo, a language designed in 1967 to teach kids how to write code. Let's start by exploring some basic code. Open Creative Suite, click Programming, and then click Turtle Tina. All our demonstrations will be in Creative Suite, and this is a free app that you can use at any time to write your own programs. Take a look at the sample code here, and I'll make it a little bigger so it's easier to see. By the end of Section 3, you'll be able to write code just like this. Let's run the code and see what it makes. Awesome! This is a 3D image, and we can rotate it in the viewer by clicking and dragging. We can also save, share, and print this file. In NCLab, there are two different ways to save your files. One way is to save the code, and you can either save it in NCLab, which will save your file to NCLab's cloud storage, or you can save it to your local disk. Another way is to export your file as an STL. An STL is the type of file that is read by 3D printers, and a lot of 3D printers have a USB port, so if you save your file to a flash drive, you can then plug that flash drive into a 3D printer and print out your creation. Now that you know how to save and print your designs, let's try some basic code. First, we'll erase the sample code. Now let's create a simple program. We'll start by naming the turtle. So I'll type Tina equals NCLab turtle. And you'll notice that after I typed NCLab turtle, the text turned red, and that's a sign that I typed it correctly. Because if I had left out a letter, it would have stayed black. Now let's give Tina a command. Tina.show. And you'll notice that in this command, I put a period next to Tina, then I typed show, and then I put parentheses. A command has to have all of these features or it won't run. Let's run the code and see what happens. And there's Tina. She's in her default mode right now, so she's colored blue, she's facing east, and she's sitting on the origin at 0, 0. And if you look at the graph, you'll see that the x-axis is red and the y-axis is green. And the interval of the squares is 10 units. Now let's add to the program. The three most common commands we'll use for Tina are go, left, and right. And these commands are written the same way as the show command. Let's say Tina.write. And inside these parentheses, I'm going to put the number of degrees I want Tina to turn. So we'll put Tina.write 90, and then Tina.go. And inside the go parentheses, I'm going to put the number of steps I want Tina to take. So let's say go 30 steps. Then let's say Tina.left 90, and Tina.go 30. Okay, let's run the program. So we can see on the graph that Tina took a 90 degree right turn, went down 30 steps, took a 90 degree left turn, and then went 30 steps to the east. To summarize, always name the turtle first. Tina's defaults are blue, facing east, and sitting on the origin. The x-axis is red, the y-axis is green, and the default interval is 10 units. You can move Tina forward using the go command, and inside those parentheses, you put the number of steps you want Tina to take, and you can make Tina turn right or left using the right or left commands, and inside those parentheses, you put the number of degrees you want Tina to turn. Let's close Creative Suite for now, and NCLab always reminds you to save your file. In the next video, we'll learn more basic commands.